and welcome to the Meeple Mentor YouTube channel. This is a Meeple Mentor review of Obsession from Dan Halligan. This is Obsession, Pride, Intrigue, and Prejudice in Victorian England. 18th century romance, if you will. I'm Jared, and with me is Holly, and we'll be discussing our thoughts and opinions on the game. And so stick around. The game, if you haven't seen it before, is essentially you are taking the role of a family of Derbyshire, you know, in the country estates, and you've got your own family estate to try to improve that. You've just come into some, you know, money, I guess, and you're trying to refurbish and expand your estate to attract not only, you know, just general reputation and better standing, mm-hmm. but actually to marry off into this family, the Fairchilds. And they live at the most beautiful, you know, highly sought after estate called the Alderley Hall. But anyway, so throughout the game, there's different rounds of like seasons and then rounds in the season. There's courtship phases where you try to actually win their affections by having a certain number of improvement tiles to your estate based on what they want that season. And then at the end, you tally up points for everything that you've built and your activities and your servants that you have in your estate. And it's all it's an intriguing game, as they say, pride and intrigue. What did you think of Obsession? We did play it twice.
Yes, I liked it.
Before we did this review.
I liked it. I liked the setup of it. I did get a little confused on the first play with not leaving the tile flipped. I was flipping it back and forth. But other than that, I liked it. It's got a good structure. You can kind of plan your moves pretty well. You've got your
estate board, I guess, the family board.
Well, the cards, the extra VP cards that you're the objectives.
Objective cards.
Yes. You can plan for that, essentially, because you know exactly what you're going for, even if you have to discard. Yeah.
There's certain moments where you do discard cards and then other rounds where you draw two. So over the course, you end up drawing four and discarding three, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
So it gives you a lot of flexibility on what you can work towards. So you've got something at the start, and then if it isn't going so well, that's the one you might discard. And then you get some more and you go, okay, how well have I sort of done on this so far?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I like the idea of the courtship mm-hmm. where you are going for service or prestige or the estate or, you know, mm-hmm. just adding up and determining who's got the most, who's
most influential or
who's courting.
Who's better at courting.
Yeah, because you're going for the Fairchild. Mm-hmm. So that's your goal. Mm-hmm. Who's better at wooing.
Wooing. Yeah.
Wooing.
It's true. There are five categories of improvements to your estate, and that's what she was talking about here. With they're color-coded, and you can purchase new ones, and basically every season there's a theme card that represents what the Fairchilds want that season. So those are the tile types that are going to add up, you know, for comparison to win their favor and affection mm-hmm. for the next season, which essentially means that you're going to get a free victory point card and one of the Fairchild cards to put into your active hand. And that's great because they have a lot of extra abilities and things like that. So there's these gentry cards, which every person in the game that's, you know, on a card is a gentry. It's like just a high class, but not quite noble family, right?
Yeah, essentially.
Yeah. Yeah, not royalty. Noble, but not royalty, whatever you want to call it. And so
your lords and ladies.
Yeah, it's one of these. what's that show that everyone watched that's like this, like, with all the English?
Are you talking about Downton Abbey?
Yeah, something like that. It's like Downton Abbey or something. Bridgerton, that's the one.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah. But it's much more interesting than I think the show or just the idea of the theme, because it's a lot of fun to play. The gameplay is very solid. So for me, as just from a gameplay perspective, I really enjoyed it. I like that the play is pretty streamlined as to what you do on your turn, even though they break it down into 8 steps, but I mean, it's pretty straightforward anyway.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like 8 steps.
Right. It's just like, hey, you're going to do all this anyway, but make sure to do it in this order case, I guess. But essentially, you select a tile, which has an activity listed on it. You put it on your player board to show that that's what you're going to try to host. There's different prestige levels of these activities, so your reputation has to at least be that much in matching the prestige. And the activity will require you to host a certain number of types of guests. So it could specify any gentry or, you know, women or men or family or what have you. And so based on what it says, you have to provide that from your active hand. So you play those out. Also, the gentry cards have their own kind of prestige rating, so you can't host anybody that you don't have the reputation for. And lastly, some cards and most of the activities have to have the specific servant type to service it. So the chosen activity has to say, like, maybe a, you know, might need a blue butler, right? So you have to put them on there, but that means you can't use your blue butler for anything else that round. And so maybe the, one of the ladies that you're inviting to this activity needs a lady's maid, which is like a little, purple, meeple, right? And so you have to be able to use one from your available servants. So anyone that has to have a servant to accompany them, you have to be able to provide or they can't join. So in some cases, since you have to provide exactly what it says, you may not be able to play. Mm-hmm. So then you resort to, well, I guess I'll just have to take a pass turn, which, you know, it's suboptimal because you only get so many actions.
I mean, it can be beneficial.
I mean, I saw her use it 2 or 3 times to great effect because she'd have one turn where she was using like 8 or 9 servants, you know, for 6 to 8 guests at a time on some really huge activities. I was like, what are you doing over there?
It's crazy. I maximized it to the best of my ability.
It was so crazy, so maximized that her next turn, she didn't have any available servants because essentially they need 2 turns to fully refresh. There is a way to refresh like 1 servant at a time by paying reputation. Mm-hmm. But at that point, you know, you're going to be losing a lot if you're going to have to refill everybody, you know, refresh.
I had a lot of servants.
She did have a lot. it was impressive to see, you know, like a huge turn, pass, refresh everybody, get all your cards back, you know.
Do it again.
And then do it right again. Like it's just back to back. So you gain money for doing hosting activities. You gain reputation. You can gain new gentry cards straight to your hand. Maybe new servants, all kinds of stuff. It's really fun. I liked it a lot. I think it played great at 2 players. We have the 2.2 edition, 2nd edition. And I do have the expansion, but we didn't include it yet. I'm thinking for the 3rd play that we do, we're going to put the expansion in, which does add new servant types and new cards that might need those servants and things like that. So I'm really looking forward to playing it again. So all that to say, if the theme is interesting to you, you're really going to like it. It's a solid game. If it's not as interesting, but you want something that's really great, 2 to 3 players, and has just kind of a unique feel of a game to it, it's not too complicated, even though I feel like the rule book can be a little daunting to look at, just on how it's organized. But coming soon, I will be doing a video tutorial for Obsession. So that should take care of that problem for you. So you don't have to read through it all. Excuse me, I can't talk today. I really liked it. I'm definitely looking forward to playing again. And of course, checking out that expansion. I think, you know, what he's done here has been a really, really cool way to sort of capture the politics, if you will, of building up your family reputation in this time period in an interesting way. It's pretty cool. What do you think?
I really liked it. It plays well. It's interesting. There's a little bit of flavor text on the cards, you know. It's nice. It's good.
You know, the game even encourages you to, like, announce everything that you're doing. Like, I'm hosting a tea party in the ballroom with Lady Tremaine or whoever.
Right.
It's pretty funny. So if you get into it and you know, I found myself getting into like a character where I couldn't change my voice. It was like I got stuck in like a British, fake British accent. I guess that's to be expected if you get into the theme a little bit. So I had to tone it down. I think it got a little annoying for her. But it's all part of the experience.
Yeah.
Well, I highly recommend it. If you get a chance to play it, definitely give it a shot. I believe it plays up to 4... maybe 5 or 6 if you have expansions for it. Because I know there's, with the expansions I have, there's like 2 more families that you can play as. So, yeah. But that's been our review. Any final thoughts? No?
Not really. Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks for tuning in to this review of Obsession. And of course, if you want to see more reviews or tutorials, like I mentioned, we also have board gaming news on the channel every other week. Stick around on the channel, hit us with a subscribe, hit that notification so you know, get notified of all our new stuff. And until then, I'll see you in the next video. I've been Jared.
I'm Holly.
Bye-bye.